Hi, Blue. How are you, Blue? Why are you so blue? Aren't fishers supposed to be green? I wonder where'd you got that blue color on you? Oh, hi, everybody, and everybody, hi. Welcome back to my channel, Birdiology. And today, we're gonna be learning about this blue mutation and how this bird got this blue color on itself. Yeah. And let's learn about it. Let's go.
Transmutation, also known as gene integration.
Rise up this morning, out on my feet, walking down the doorway into the street. Welcome to my journey, Birdiology.
In our last video, we learned about the four eye ring lovebirds and how to identify each species, and we learned that any of these eye rings can interbreed with each other, creating hybrids. And these hybrids are fertile and can produce offsprings. Not only these hybrids can cause extinction of a species, they also contaminate the gene pool of a pure species that developed and evolved for thousands of years. And basically, hybrids are of low quality. But aside of all this undesirable reputation of hybrids, we can look at the positive side of it. The good part of hybridization is that hybrids has improved traits. Just like in plants, hybrid plants has improved its growth rate, biomass, stress tolerance, and fertility. And this also happens in animals. We call this hybrid vigor or heterosis. But in lovebirds, we focus on breeding color mutations. Each time a new color mutations come into existence, just like the new yellow-faced fishery, many breeders will race to transfer the mutation to the other three species of the eye ring family. The process of this transfer is called transmutation, also known as genetic introgression. Species are crossed with each other to transfer the characteristics or traits like size, colors, and even behaviors. In the case of transmutation in lovebirds, the idea is to transfer the new color mutation to the other species until you reach its purest form, not only physically, but also genotypically. Remember that transmutation is still hybridization, so we need to be careful and follow the right process if you are planning to do transmutations. There are different ways to do transmutations the right way. Let's use the blue factor as an example. The blue mutation originated from the Personatus and was transmuted to the other three eye ring lovebirds. So remember, if you see the blue factor on the fishery, Nigogenes, and in the Lilianae, keep in mind that these birds are still hybrids, even though they look like pures. So let's start with the first method. We have a blue Personatus and we are going to transfer the blue factor to the fishery. So we'll need a wild type fisher, 100% pure, without carrying any other mutation, and definitely not a hybrid. So we have a 100% blue Personatus and a 100% pure green fishery. We cross them together, and to your surprise, all of their babies are green. This is because the blue factor is a recessive mutation. It means that you need two copies of that gene to see it physically or phenotypically. Basically, both the mother and the father must be carrying the blue factor in their blood to produce blue babies. But don't worry, all of these green offsprings are split for the blue factor or are carriers of the blue mutation. Clearly, these babies are hybrids. They are now 50% Personatus and 50% fishery. We can now call them F1 or the first filial generation. We then need to backcross them to another pure green fisher. On a backcross or reverse crossing, we name the offsprings R1, R2, and so on. These are now the first R generation. They are all green, and 50% of the babies are split or carriers for blue, and 50% are normal greens. These R1 generation are now 75% fishery and 25% Personatus. And now, we will cross them with each other or we will be doing inbreeding. We know that only half or 50% of these are carriers of the blue gene. Remember that there are no clues or physical signs that could indicate that a bird is a split or a carrier of a recessive gene. Now, because we know that only 50% of these birds are split to blue, we need to find those carriers by randomly testing them for breeding. If we are lucky and we paired both splits or both carriers, we will now have our first blue transmutant. This transmutant will definitely look like a hybrid. It will also only have 50% fishery blood. Remember that if we cross siblings or did inbreeding, we fall back or downgrade to the previous percentage. Instead of getting 87.5% purity, when we bred the 75% siblings, we fell back to 50%. So be cautious about this. Now, about our first blue transmutant. We will cross it again with a 100% pure grin fisher. This will be like our second parental generation. Their offsprings will be the second filial generation, or we call them F2. We backcross them again with a pure grin fisher and we get the R2 generation, which are 50% split for blue, and cross them with each other, and if you're lucky that you've paired both splits, you get the second blue transmutant. And again, we pair it again with a pure fishery, and the cycle continues. We need at least 5 blue generations for a good result. The 5th blue generation will look clean and looking a lot like a pure fishery, but still have the personatus genes. Be aware that if you pair this with an F2 or any of the previous birds from this breeding, it will degrade its purity fast. The results can go back to lower percentage of purity. If you already have a 99.9% bird, you may come back to the 90 or 80%. All your effort will be wasted. So always breed with pure birds to increase the purity of our transmutant. Now, let's proceed to the next method. This is just a shortcut of the previous method. We will again use the blue factor to transfer it from the personatus to the fishery. So we cross a 100% blue personatus to a 100% wild type fisher. 100% of the progenies are split for blue, and this time we will cross them with each other. We are sure that they are all carriers for blue, so we only need to look for a male and a female and cross them together, and 50% of those babies will be split for blue, 25% are normal green, and a 25% chance of having a blue. In this method, we already have a blue transmutant in just 2 generations. We start again by pairing that blue to another pure grin fisher, and the cycle continues. So again, we need to produce 5 blue generations to have good specimens. This second method is less advisable because of too much inbreeding, but it's way faster than the first method. Now, we move on to the third method. This method is for dominant mutations. Basically, a dominant mutation will always show or express the mutation on its offsprings. You only need one parent of that dominant mutation to produce a mutant. Babies that doesn't show the mutations are just normals. They will not carry the mutation and definitely are not split for that mutation. Now, let's use the Ewing mutation for this transmutation. The Ewing originated from the fishery, so we will transmute it from the fishery to the personatus. We start by crossing a 100% pure Ewing fishery to a 100% pure wild-type personatus. So the result is that half or 50% of the babies are Ewings, and all of the offsprings have 50% DNA of a fishery and 50% DNA of a personatus. These will be our F1 hybrids. Then, we backcross or reverse cross the Ewing back to a pure personatus and we'll have the first R generation Ewing. Most people name them as F2s, but clearly it must be of the R generation. To avoid confusions, just declare the percentage of the purity of the bird. Now, these Ewings will have 75% fishery DNA and 25% personatus DNA. We again backcross the Ewing progeny to another pure personatus and we have a 87.5% fisher perso hybrid. These birds will look like hybrids. So you need to do these reverse crossings or back crossings up to 15 times to achieve better results, and you can acclaim that you have successfully transmutated a particular mutation to another species. Yet, these good quality transmutants are still considered as hybrid because it will be very difficult to make these birds pure. It will take years, maybe a lifetime. I did the math on the R generations and it will take 54 generations. Yes, 54 generations to totally wipe out the DNA of the original species from the transmutant. Let's say that every pair will take a year to start breeding. It will take 54 years or more to achieve that pure transmutant. And in those 54 generations, we also need 54 pure wild-type birds. And pure birds are hard to find because of hybridization. And what about all the hybrids that were created? These birds are of no use for breeding. These birds must be kept as pets only, and without the knowledge of the pet owner, he tries to breed them and more hybrids will circulate and could end up in anyone's aviary, and soon we're left with no pure birds. If only we could neuter and spay these hybrids to stop them from breeding, that would be great. I don't recommend doing transmutation because of these. Imagine if all breeders will do transmutation. It will be catastrophic and disastrous. And before you ever thought about doing this, many breeders already succeeded on that project. So I recommend just getting an established transmutant and go on pairing it with a good wild form. And by the way, about doing the math on the percentage of the purity of the offsprings. So we start by addition and dividing it to two. So we have both 100% parents. The species where we transfer the mutation will be zero because it will not inherit anything, and add it to 100 and divide it by 2, and you have 50% purity. So that 50% purity plus 100% divided by 2 equals 75%. 75 plus 100 divided by 2 is 87.5, and so on. Just keep on crossing the transmutant until you reach 99.99 and you will have the proper transmutant. You can then call them Bluefisher and Ewing Personatus, but that will cost you 15 years or more. I don't know, it may take longer depending how fast or how long your lovebirds breed. So I think that's all about it for now. I hope you've learned something and I hope that you can apply this on your bird breeding. And yeah, make sure to like, comment, share, subscribe, and for those who already did transmutation successfully, goodbye everybody and everybody, goodbye, God bless you, and happy bird keeping. Yeah! Let's go, buddy. Let's go, Blue. Let's go. Come on. Oh, let's go, Blue. Say bye-bye. Bye-bye. Birdiology.